From a huge crowd here outside LA Live, it's for an Australian Nathan Haas on an American team Garmin Barracuda.
Well, you can see the damage it's done. There's the main field now. The peloton are coming very quickly indeed.
They're right on the wheels. They're picking up the remnants as they go through with a lap to go. The bell is ringing. I hope they can hear it above the noise here. The spread is still 17 seconds, but now that's only to the leader, Nathan Haas.
Well, Nathan Haas now has got to do something extremely special. One thing he does know is Garmin Barracuda will not chase him down. They'll be up to the other teams now. And again, for me, that gives the advantage to Heinrich Hausler. He can sit there and use the other teams to keep the pace nice and high. But at 7 kilometres to go, or 4.5 miles of racing, Phil, this is not going to take them very much more than 9 minutes.
This young man here has a terrific future ahead of him. I wonder if they realise who he is back in the peloton. They won't have seen too much of him yet. He shot to the top last year towards the end. He won the Japan Cup. He also won a very famous race in Australia, which is the Jayco Sun Tour. And now he's on a big team. He can time trial. He's gone clear. There's still a few remnants chasing, including Scott Rizanski, also chasing along with Stiveson. They're trying to reach him. The peloton may have been outwitted here.
Well, Jesper Stuyven, the rider in the black jersey there, he's one of the riders on the Bontrager under 23 development squad, and he is learning a lot about his trade this afternoon. This man has now got the bit between his teeth, as they would say in horse racing. He's got some very aerodynamic wheels on. He's zigzagging around there. That's to miss one or two of the manhole covers. This could create the bit of a surprise, but as you can see, it's Orica Greenedge doing the pacemaking now, but there's still not one team has got themselves organized, and I'm waiting for somebody to take over the control. I would expect Robert Hessing now to be feeling rather confident. He's the man in the yellow jersey, should run out the overall winner. He's ticking over these final few kilometres.
Well, the Optum team are moving to the front here, but they don't want to move too close because they've still got Scott Rizanski up here trying to reach Nathan Haas at the moment. So they might be forming a false pace behind to try and distract the chase. This is Nathan Haas, the biggest moment he's had at the world of top pro cycling here. He's making his bid for victory on the last day of the Amgen Tour of California. And still the race is under the control of the Rabobank. Now there's only one rider left in front, and that is the Australian Haas.
A little bit of a difficult tactical decision there. You can see on the left-hand side, Garmin Barracuda, they're forming a line to try and lead out their sprinter, and that, of course, is Heinrich Hausler, but they can't chase their own man. They're going to leave it all to the other teams. There's Robert Hessink in third position there in the yellow jersey, still riding at the front. He doesn't need to mix it up with these guys, Phil, but he wants to make sure that he keeps out of any chance of danger and an accident at the final few kilometres.
Absolutely. And on this stage today, it's a complicated rule, but if he gets inside 1.8 miles to go at 3 kilometres, with this group and falls or crashes, he will get the same time, so therefore he cannot lose the race. And that's what he'll be thinking at the moment. He's got to get inside that last 2 miles of this circuit.
You can see on the left-hand side, two teams of two very fast sprinters have got themselves a good organisation. The lime green jerseys are Liquigas Cannondale. They've got the man just behind in the green jersey, and that, of course, Peter Sagan. He's won 4 stages of this Amgen Tour of California so far, and he's still hungry for one more.
Well, we'll all have to cheer for Heinrich Hausler, who's finished second 4 times to Peter Sagan. Once they wipe out the leader, they're going to come down together. Those two must go head-to-head. It is a pure sprinter's stage.
Well, all of a sudden, Nathan Haas has been caught,
right,
and
to
he's
the bunch.
Right at the back end of the main field.
We're swept away. We're all together. 110 survivors on this year's Amgen Tour of California are going to battle out the final stage. They can't win the race overall, but they can win the last stage in front of an enormous crowd here at LA Live. Now, watch out for Peter Sagan. We'll pin him for you when we can. He's the dark green in the centre of the light greens in that jersey of points leader. His team have looked for him, and they've brought him to the front.
4.5 kilometres to go. That's inside of 3 miles of racing. Luis Leon Sanchez is the Spanish rider on the Dutch Rabobank team on the front, doing the final few turns to keep this pace nice and high. Motorbike was a little bit close there, but look at Luis Leon Sanchez. Looks over his shoulder. He knows that very, very shortly, a team of one of the sprinters will take up the responsibility of lifting this pace again to close to 35 miles an hour.
They continue. Now, in 1.3 kilometres, Robert Gesing can be crowned the winner of this race, because a problem after that doesn't help him. It doesn't help anybody else. They're all together as they race to the finish. The field of 110 riders. It's all about who wins the day. And can Peter Sagan, who won the first 4 days of this race, finish off with a win in Los Angeles?
Most important thing now going through the minds of the sprinters, Phil, is the positioning. You've got to be in the right place. If you're 15th or 20th position too far back, you've got to scuttle up the outside to try and keep yourself in the first five or six places. Garmin Barracuda now decided those are the riders in the blue jerseys and the blue helmets. They are looking after their sprinter Heinrich Hausler. He's gone back a little bit, but still, I have to say, Rabobank in the orange jersey here are doing a phenomenal job. They just want to get it over and done with. They just want to grab the yellow jersey, Robert Gesing, and take him to the finish line and deposit him there right in front of LA Live for a great victory.
But they also might be looking now for Michael Matthews to try and get him to the line, because Matthews is the sprinter. He was knocked around a couple of days in this race, but he seems to be back on form. He's been up in the places on one occasion. He's had a fourth, and Matthews will have the same orange jersey on as the man setting the pace. They're setting the pace for him. They've got a double-pronged attack here right now.
Well, actually, Michael Matthews is in not a very good position there. He slipped back a bit. He's got two teammates right on the front, but now there's a looks like there's another move trying to come off the front end of the peloton here.
This, and this United Healthcare having a go to try and steal the race away from everybody else.
And what this does, Phil, it creates confusion for the teams of the sprinters when you see these last-minute attacks, but I don't think he's going anywhere at all. He made the initial acceleration, but then when you start to get that wind smacking into your face, it's a wrong decision to make.
Well, it looks as though it might be Brad White here who's made a move to try and draw the attraction, because they have a sprinter in Jeff Lauder back in the main field. But look at the lumbering big gears of the men in orange as they bring up. And on the left, those light blue jerseys are the team of Tom Bonen, the big sprinter from Belgium, who is currently the world's number one ranked rider this year. He came here to win at least one stage and has won none. He's now moving up to the front. He's going to take Sagan on.
Well, I tell you what, this is the moment when you've got to keep calm if you're a sprinter. You've got to trust your teammates. You've got to expect your teammates to slowly move you to the front end of the peloton. When we go around the corners, you can't touch your brakes if you're a sprinter. You've got to make sure you don't touch them, because if you do, you slip back that down that line of riders into 15th or 20th position. Then you've got to use energy to get right back up to the front again. I have to say that Omega Quickstep have got a very good organization. These are the riders in the pale blue jerseys. At the back of that line will be Tom Bonen.
You bet your life he's right. The big man on the left, the last of those boys in the turquoise tops, that is Tom Bonen there. Also behind him, Heinrich Hausler is getting in position. And here comes the rush on the left too of the black-topped riders from Orica Greenedge, bringing forward Lee Howard and Robbie McEwen as they get into the last 1.5 kilometres now. This looks like they've got it well organised. The team from Belgium, Omega Pharma Quickstep, have got Tom Bonen, last of the group.
This is called the lead-out train, and what they do, they sacrifice themselves. The man on the front will ride as hard and as long as he can. They're inside the Kenda 1 kilometer to go mark now. They're going to take less than 60 seconds to get to the finishing line. The riders of a team like that, like Tom Bonen, they'll peel off one by one, and in theory then they let Tom Bonen, but look how it's getting squashed around the corners there by the Liquigas riders in their lime green jerseys. They're trying to set it up for Peter Sagan once again.
Sagan is in there. He is the darker green of the lime green jerseys. There he is, far right now. He's moving his own. That's an XC rider gone onto his shoulder. So there are two riders possible. That's Fred Rodriguez who's moved up there, the sprinter on Team Exidy, right on the shoulder of Sagan. They're both waiting. They're going down 600 metres. This is the lineup for the finish now. They will see the finish.
We are now approaching 40 miles an hour. Bonan's up there into second position. They've gone round this corner in perfect lineup. Bonen is in second place. Right behind him there is Peter Sagan. A little bit further back is Heinrich Hausler.
As they go for the line now, Tom Bonen is the second wheel. This is the best chance he's had the whole race. Is he going to be there? Goes Sagan. Sagan is on the left. Bonen is taking him on. Peter Sagan drives to the line. It is win number 5 for him. Unbelievable. He is just too quick. And this time, Tom Bonen has got second. Well, in that peloton is the yellow jersey of Robert Gesing, a Dutchman for the first time in this race history has won the Amgen Tour of California, and he becomes only the second non-American to do so. Peter Sagan, the not yet 23 years of age man from Slovakia, has won stage 5 of the stage, his 5th stage, as he comes down into LA Live.
Well, I have to say Omega Pharma Quickstep got everything right there, Phil, but you just can't stop this man from Slovakia, Peter Sagan. The team are here. They're giving him all of the congratulations that he needs. 22 years of age. That's his eighth victory of the season. He had 15 wins last year. I wonder how many he's going to get this year, and he's going to be a trouble for the sprinters in the Tour de France in July.
Well, Mark Cavendish, who is the great British sprinter, who's won 20 stages of the Tour de France, better watch out in July, because he's going to be taking on this man who's never ridden in the Tour de France yet. He just powered away from Tom Bonan, got him right on the line. Tom Bonan is shaking his head, can't believe it.
Well, he did it right. It was his teammate Gerard Scholeck who was leading him out, himself a very good sprinter. This is the photo finish. He's got that by half a wheel. You can see how Tom Bonan is lunging his bike, but it was too late for Big Tom. And third place, I think, will go to Gerard Scholeck of Germany and the same team as Tom Bonan.
Yeah, so second and third for the Omega Quickstep team there, and a win for Peter Sagan. Let's not forget, though, the man who has won this race is the yellow jersey, Robert Gesink. He stole the jersey with a great show of panache yesterday on the dizzy heights of Mount Baldy. He came down overnight to Los Angeles, moved out to Beverly Hills this morning, and came home today as the winner of the Amgen Tour of California. Let's hope that for Robert Gesink now, all of his sadnesses are behind him.
Yes, well, poor old Tom Bonan got himself second place. Peter Sagan is unbelievable. There's confirmation there. Sagan gets ahead of Tom Bonan, Gerhard Scholeck of Germany, and Omega Pharma Quickstep. And another German rider up there in third place, Roger Klug for Team Argos Shimano. But that was an incredible sprint, very fast. You would probably be looking at close to 70 kilometers an hour, that acceleration, as we look down there on the Staples Center. That's where in about half an hour's time they'll be dropping the puck on the ice, and a big hockey game will kick off with the LA Kings taking on the Phoenix Coyotes in the final game, the game of seven, and it is a deciding match as to who goes forward to the Stanley Cup Finals.